What's up, guys? Welcome back, Lagan, to the channel. He is bringing you guys the top 5 best zombie bosses in COD history. And if you guys want to see more from him on my channel, drop a like, put in the comment section what you'd like to see. The guy is a zombie extraordinaire, so that would be his forte. Let him know if you want to see anything else Call of Duty zombie top 5-ish. Here we go. Enjoy the video.
I will make them go boom now.
It's your boy, Lagan24, coming at you with the top 5 zombie bosses in Call of Duty history. What's up, everybody? You guys picked these on Twitter, and I'm not quite sure what the criteria is for a zombie boss making a top 5 list. Maybe some of you guys picked it because you love these guys and you find them fun to play against. Maybe some of you picked these 5 because you hate these guys and they make it really challenging to play against. Well, whatever the case is, we've got a top 5. Let's jump right into it. When I mentioned I was doing a top 5 list on Twitter, you guys flooded me with all kind of tweets suggesting which 5 should make the list. I took the most popular 5. However, there was one who got a lot of tweets but did not quite make the top 5 list. So an honorable mention goes out to the man on the moon, the astronaut zombie, the cosmonaut zombie. As you can see, he was requested quite a few times but just didn't make the list. Let's hop into number 5. Coming in at number 5 is the thief from the map 5. And he comes after the power's been turned on every 4 to 6 rounds-ish. And what he does is he comes up and steals your gun that you have equipped in your hands. It is up to you and your team then to chase him around through a maze of teleporters and try and kill him before he escapes the Pentagon. If you are successful in killing him, not only will you get your gun returned to you, you get a max ammo and a fire sale. And if you are actually able to kill him before he even takes your gun, you're going to get a max ammo, you're going to get a bonfire sale, which links all the teleporters to the Pack-a-Punch room and drops the price of Pack-a-Punch from 5,000 to 1,000. Sadly, if you don't kill him before he escapes, your gun is gone forever. And that was number 5. Let's move on to number 4. Coming in at number 4 is Brutus from Mob of the Dead, and if you hear a prison cell slam shut and your screen starts shaking, you better turn around and look, because there is possibly this large, towering, very angry warden or prison guard right behind you. His name's Brutus, and he doesn't play games. He is heavily armored, and if you want to kill him, the most effective way to do it is to shoot off his helmet. That'll allow for headshots, and then you can take him down pretty easily after that. However, when he finally does go down, he will let off a large cloud of smoke. I think those are smoke grenades, and it'll obscure your view for about 20 to 30 seconds. He'll also leave you a power up upon his death. However, while he's alive, if he passes a Perca-Cola machine, a workbench, the mystery box, or the plane, he will lock it down, making it to where you cannot use those items until you pay 2,000 points to unlock them. He is not affected by the acid trap or the fan trap. However, you can kill him with the tower trap if you're lucky enough to keep him in the area long enough. And that's number 4. Let's move on to number 3. Coming in at number 3, Forged from Satan's Balls, or the Hellhounds. Or actually, they're just kind of mutated versions of Samantha's pet Fluffy. But whatever, the first way sounded a little more cool. These guys come every 5 to 6 rounds. They can be found on mini maps, first seen on Shinonuma. You can even, through custom games in Green Run, on Black Ops 2, you can set them to appear as well, although they're very easy to deal with in Black Ops 2. There's 2 types of hellhounds. There's the fire hellhound, which will explode when you shoot it and kill it, and that could cause some extra damage if you're nearby. And then there's a normal hellhound that will not explode. He'll just fall to his death. Once you kill these guys, they'll leave you a max ammo, except for sometimes on Shinonuma, they will leave you nothing. It'll actually be the very first zombie you kill in the next round that will drop your max ammo for you. I love these guys. I think they're great. Fetch me their souls. Let's move on to number 2. Coming in at number 2 is George A. Romero from Call of the Dead. He appears on the map in round 1 and he's very slow and he mumbles a bunch of phrases. He follows you around the map the entire game, and if you get too close to him or you shoot at him, you will agitate him, putting him in a berserker type state, and he will sprint after you trying to hit you with a stage light. He can also hit other zombies with a stage light and make them agitated, and they'll sprint faster at you. You can calm him down by leading him back to the water, and he will slowly walk around the map again. Now, you can actually make George retreat for a round if you kill him. Technically, not kill him. He's just retreating. But he has a lot of health, 250,000 health per player that's playing. The 3 guns that work the best to kill him is the Pack-a-Punch, Dragunov, or the L96A, they both do 10,000 damage per shot. And of course, the scavenger pack a punch is a really nice way to go as well. If you kill George or make him go away, he will spawn a death machine and a random perk bottle. Or if you've completed the Easter egg, he will actually spawn a random perk bottle and the Wunderwaffe DG2. He's a very annoying character on a very awesome map. He was number two. Let's see what's number one. Coming in at number one in overwhelming fashion. You guys voted for it, so here you go. It's the Panzer Soldat from the map Origins. Panzer Soldat stands for Armored Soldier, and this guy is armored from head to toe. He comes flying in on jetpack. He's got a claw that he can shoot at you. He's also got a flamethrower. He's got a very strong melee that will kill anyone with Juggernog in two hits, and if you don't have Juggernog, he can put you down with his melee in one hit. The best way to kill him is to shoot at the glass paneling in front of his face, and then you can shoot at his head. He is a formidable opponent. Definitely a challenge. And with giant robot feet slamming down, you oftentimes will get distracted and get squished or killed by him. He comes every 4 to 5 rounds if you're playing solo, every 3 to 4 rounds if you're playing co-op. He can only come once No Man's Land has been opened, and he will drop you a part to the fire staff, the first one you kill. Everyone after that will drop a power up. I love this guy. I think this was a great choice for number one. If you agreed with this list, great. If you didn't, that's also fine. Leave your own list down below. Don't forget to leave a like. Thank you for watching. And as always, it's been your boy Lagging24, and I will see you next time.